Welcome to another GearCaster review. Today we're having a look at the Bleuet Pocket Stove, or Bleuet if you're French, from AGS Brands. It's a super ultra lightweight stove made from galvanized steel. It weighs only 3.25 ounces. And the base has two sides which pop open for your pot support, so you can just rest your pot on top of that. They open all the way as well too if you want to use it for bigger pots or even more as an open fire. It comes with six different fuel tabs, solid fuel tabs, and these are in waterproof casing, so you know they're not going to get wet while you're on the trail. And you just take a fuel tab and place it at the base of the stove. These light super easy with matches or lighters. You could probably use if you have a steel flint as well too, that might work to set these on fire. They make great fire starters too, so if you're in a place where you can have a campfire, you can put a solid fuel tablet in there and they'll try and help get the campfire going. A sliced up onion and a raw one. So once we get the fire going here, the biggest test for me of any sort of camping stove or backpacking stove is how long is it going to take to make my coffee in the morning? So it's pretty much the same test as boiling how long does it going to take to boil a pot of water for my dehydrated meals. For me, the key is how long is it going to take to make my coffee. So I've got my Southern Yosemite Mountain Guides coffee here, the blend. It's probably my favorite coffee for hiking and backpacking. And I'm going to stick it in my coffee, my backcountry coffee maker, and see how long this takes. So you can see the fire in the back is starting to go pretty well. Each fuel tablet is supposed to last for about 15 minutes. And as you'll see in a bit, the intensity is pretty strong to start with. And you could probably use a really ultra lightweight windscreen, such as some aluminum foil or something to kind of help these burn better. So I'm going to time how long it takes to make my coffee here. Drop a nickel in my pot. We're about, 9:40 in, almost 10 minutes in, and you can look at the solid fuel tablet. It's still burning, but it's not that intense, and there's still no sign of the coffee coming through the percolator yet. So that's 10 minutes, and we still don't have any coffee, and we're getting to the end of the life of the single fuel tablet. So what I decided to do was add a second fuel tablet to add a little bit more intensity and see if we could get the coffee going then. So far we're doing two solid fuel tablets and, over 10 minutes to get just a simple pot of coffee in the morning. So these aren't going to be as intense as, let's say, your jet boil gas stove that you have. But it does weigh only 3 ounces plus the solid fuel. So you could probably add some sticks if you want to one of the solid fuel tablets to get it going. So here we finally got some, you can see the coffee's coming through the top, starting to bubble up through the percolator. So that's a good sign. We've got a pretty good fire going under there now as well too with the second fuel tablet in there. So that's about, I think we're at over 15 minutes though for a pot of coffee in the morning. So yep, 15:41 for the coffee, it's almost done. And you can see this black stuff at the bottom of the coffee pot as well as on the stove. These solid fuel tablets leave a sticky dark residue on the bottom of your pots and also on the stove, which can be a bit gross and get all over your stuff in your pack. So if you're worried about that, you might want to somehow be able to wipe that off while you're out in the back country, or if you don't really care, it's not that big of a deal. But yay, we finally have our coffee. And you can see the second solid fuel tablet's still burning because it's only been in there for probably about 6-7 minutes, so it's probably about halfway through its life. The great thing about the solid fuel tablets and the stove is there's no residue left over, so you have no ashes, no anything to clean up. You just kind of fold up your stove, throw it in the bag, and you're ready to go. So if you're an ultralight thru-hiker and you just want to be able to boil water on the trail, or even if you want to have a stove in your backpack for emergency situations, then you might want to check out the Bleuet Pocket Stove.